The college football experience, Texas Tech Red Raiders 2022 season preview episode on the college football experience is brought to you by WinBet. Bet $100 at WinBet and get a $100 free bet. Head over to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/WinBet. That's sportsgamblingpodcast.com/WYNNBET to claim your free bet today. We're also brought to you by IP Vanish. Yes, IP Vanish is the official VPN of SGPN, and they're offering 70% off if you go to ipvanish.com/SGP. That's ipvanish.com/SGP. We're also brought to you by Draft Day 2.0. Yes, make sure to check out Draft Day 2.0 starting on August 9th at noon Pacific. Ryan Real Money Kramer of the Sports Gambling Podcast will begin drafting for 24 straight hours. It is a fantasy football marathon, but it's also a fantasy football marathon that will raise money for Daryl, a loyal listener who was recently injured in a motorcycle accident. So head to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/draft day for more details.
Hey, what's up, you degenerate gamblers? This is Bill Burr, and you're listening to SGPN. Let it ride, baby.
Yes, yes, yes. Woo-hoo!
Welcome. Welcome to the college football experience. Texas Tech Red Raiders 2022 season preview episode. My name is Colby Swinging Dantabase Dan, AKA Pick Dundee. That's not a pick. This is a pick.
He was raised in the land down under, where a man thinks on his feet, speaks with his fists, and lives by his wits.
When Dundee happened, he was a superstar.
I smoke and I drink and I don't have stress and I'm healthy.
Bombarding them with Dundee clips. You are now rocking with Dundee. Hopefully you're watching on YouTube. Subscribe to the College Football Experience wherever you listen to podcasts at, but watch on YouTube as well. And remember, subscribe to the College Basketball Experience. Chris Beard, we don't need him. We got Mark Adams. I love Red Raider Nation and what they're doing on the hardwood. And I'm excited to talk about them on the gridiron. I am joined by my co-host. Give it up for former JMU Duke defensive back, the burrito eating, sideline kiss stealing, wheeling and dealing, Patty C in the place to be.
Hi-oh! Well.
Buddy. Yes, we love college football. Yeah, 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 yeah. We love Red Raider football. Billy Joe Tolliver to Sonny Cumby. We love Red Raider football. Yes, 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 yes. From Bam Morris to Byron Hansbard, we love Red Raider football, yeah. Have they turned us off yet, Patty C? Have the listeners said, who the fuck is this idiot? But yes, I am an idiot, but I'm an idiot that knows Red Raider football. Friend of the program, we are Mike Leach. We are friends of the program for Mike One Leach.
Oh, yeah.
And he always tells us, hey, I love the people of Lubbock. Just kind of still waiting for the university to owe him some money. But hey,
administration's got some things they got to work out.
Look, they had some tough years. Those are the football gods getting even with Texas Tech.
They paid their dues.
And Patty C, I'll be honest, there was a lot of talk that they would hire Sonny Dykes this past year. TCU ended up hiring Sonny Dykes. And TCU also recently got into some Twitter beef about who wants to go play in a desert. And then and really ignited. Joey McGuire has helped ignite the Texas Tech Red Raider fans about this dispute on Twitter. But anyway,
West Texas football.
I love
very
it.
Proud Friday Night Lights, baby.
Nothing wrong with a cactus in the desert. You know what I mean?
Amen.
But I actually thought this is if you would have made me athletic director, I would have hired Joey McGuire by a mile over Sonny Dykes. And I know Sonny Dykes' dad, Spike Dykes, former Texas Tech coach in the 80s and 90s or whatever, but I think Joe McGuire is a sneaky, sneaky good hire. He's in year one. What do you make of the hire?
It's tough to say. I mean, I don't know a ton about the guy. He was kind of under the radar last year. He's 50 years old. This is his first head coaching gig since he was a high school coach. And so, you know, other than that, he's just been at Baylor since 2017. So I don't know a ton about him.
There's a lot of success there.
Yeah, and he's been with them.
He's been the glue that kind of held them together.
He's got a good reputation.
And I can tell you this. I love what he did from bringing in Tim DeRuiter to D.C.
It's a nice hire.
And also Zach Kittley at the OC spot.
It's a great hire.
That's what I'm saying. I think it's a sneaky good hire. I think Texas Tech could be on their way back. Could be on their way back to the Leach days. So
Kittley, UT Arlington is Joey McGuire's alma mater. So I think I would guess that unless he goes the Chris Beard route, that Texas Tech may be a final destination for him. But we did notice that Kittley was the Texas Tech alum.
That's true.
And he had the number two offense in the country last year, and by far the number one.
And I watched this kid when he was the OC at Houston Baptist. So I knew about Bailey Zappe a couple years ago. Yeah. And then when he brought him with him, and he brought the Stearns brothers, I believe, and another wideout to Western Kentucky, I knew that offense was going to fly. So Dundee
lit it up
ahead of the curve.
Dundee watching these chess moves well in advance.
Yes.
This kid's only 30 years old.
He's going to, and telling you that, he's a money offensive
coordinator. Is he the future of Texas Tech football, or are they going to lose him to a bigger job?
Who knows? Who knows? We will see.
But Joey McGuire is the guy for right now.
Yes.
For sure.
Show me the money, says Joey McGuire. 50th in scoring offense a season ago. Once again, that was not Joey McGuire. That was not Zach Kittley. This was a couple different coaches. Matt Wells and Sonny Cumbie, 50th in scoring offense, 71st in rush offense, 39th in pass offense, 56th in total offense, Patty C. But Kittley comes in and he's got a good problem. You know what the good problem is? He's got two capable quarterbacks, Tyler Shough from Oregon, who was a top recruit over there. I know you're a big fan.
Oh yeah. He was the, Michael Pratt before Michael Pratt.
Yeah. And he transferred to Texas Tech a little over a season ago. And then Donovan Smith, who won the bowl game against Coach Leach, looked pretty good. So they have two capable quarterbacks, Patty C, and then Kittley's offense. You're gonna fire that laser all over the field. They got a couple good running backs in Tahj Brooks and SaRodorick Thompson. Pretty sound at the running back spot. Wide receiver, something we got to question a little bit. They got just one of three back, Myles Price. Tight end, they're breaking in a new tight end, but Baylor Cupp, former four-star from Texas A&M, transfers in. They get three of five starters back on the O-line, led by Cole Spencer. I know Cole. He always blocks good, all right? To quote Days of Thunder, defensive coordinator, like I said, Tim DeRuiter, and I think he is a pretty damn good defensive coordinator, comes over from Oregon, 95th in scoring defense, 40th in rush defense. Well, obviously this wasn't his defense last year. 95th in scoring defense, 40th in rush defense, 119th in pass defense, 86th in total defense. I expect those numbers to be better. How fast can he do it is the question, Patty C.
Let me ask you this. Do you think this throwing the ball all around the field lends itself to good defense being played? Out of curiosity, I'm going to look at what Western Kentucky's defensive rating
was.
Number? Oh, no, that's Western Michigan. Western Kentucky, number 108 in the country, despite having the number two offense in the country. Moves a little fast. It's going to be hard to play some great defense when you're throwing the ball around
something
like that.
Something to circle, something to be concerned about, but Tim DeRuiter did a good job at Oregon. Ask Ohio State fans about what happened with the Ducks last year.
Hello.
Two or three back on the D-line, led by Tyree Wilson. Just one linebacker back, and that's Krishan Merriweather. I feel like Merriweather's though. Normally Brandon, Mike Merriweather, they're good at defense, right?
He was supposedly the spring practice MVP. So that's
there you
a
go.
Good look.
Four or five back in the secondary, led by safety Marquise Muddy Waters.
Boom.
If folks out there don't know, my dog is named Muddy Waters. So shout out to Marquise.
This guy's clearly a dog.
Yeah, he is a dog. And shout out to the OG Blues legend, Muddy Waters. He's fucking fantastic. Breaking in a new kicker, but their punter is back. Punt away.
Could
you're not
going
to need to punt when you have Zach Kittley.
That's true. I mean, is this air raid concepts? Like, I mean, when you're throwing the ball that much, Western Kentucky, 433 passing yards per game. Next up, Virginia in the country with 392. And then then it drops.
Just destroying that.
That's so much passing.
Zappy. Shuck is going to be the next Zappy.
Yeah. I mean, Tyler Shuck might live up to the hype, and he's got the look, doesn't he?
Oh, that's going to be great. It's going to be great.
Shuck.
Look, we're going to talk transfer portal. We're going to talk recruiting rankings, the future of Texas Tech football, what Las Vegas expects from the Red Raiders in 2022, and what we expect. We're going to go game by game on the schedule. But first, I got to get us paid. I want to tell you that the Texas Tech Red Raiders 2022 season preview episode on the Sports Gambling Podcast Network is presented by WinBet. Bet $100 at WinBet and get a $100 free bet. Head over to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/winbet. That's sportsgamblingpodcast.com/WYNNBET to claim your free bet today. We're also brought to you by IP Vanish. IP Vanish is the official VPN of SGPN, and they're offering 70% off if you go to ipvanish.com/SGP. That's ipvanish.com/SGP. We're also brought to you by Odds Trader. Odds Trader is the place to compare odds from all the major sports books. You can also compare the different signup codes and promo codes from sportsbook to sportsbook, and it will give you the best deal available. The app also provides player statistics, key game stats, injury reports, projected game day weather for bettors to make the most informed bets possible. It also has a bet tracker, so you can keep track of all your records, all your sports, all your games that you're betting on. So go to oddstrader.com/bluewire. That's Odds Trader, the number one site for all your game day bets. All right, we are back talking Red Raider football, Patty C. Incoming transfers. I alluded to Baylor Cupp, the four-star tight end from Texas A&M. Watch out for him. But defensive lineman Sam Carroll coming in from Washington State. Offensive lineman Ty Buchanan coming in from USC. Offensive tackle Cole Spencer, who I alluded to, from Western Kentucky. Defensive lineman Myles Cole from ULM. That was a good get. He was good in the Sun Belt last year. Offensive tackle Monroe Mills from Oklahoma State. And Mike Gundy, wide receiver Brady Boyd from the Minnesota Golden Gophers. Offensive tackle Michael Shanahan from UT Martin and the Skyhawks. Cornerback Keon Blankenbaker from the Wyoming Cowboys. Quarterback Jacob Rodriguez from UVA. Offensive lineman Cade Briggs from New Mexico, linebacker Dimitri Moore from Missouri State, and Road Rash Face, a.k.a. Bobby Petrino, and athlete Jordan Brown from the Kansas Jayhawks, and safety Tyler Owens from the Texas Longhorns. What do you make of that portal, Patty? See, I guess I got to touch base on what they lost, because they did lose some key pieces, too. So
it seems like some decent additions, though.
It does seem like they had some
Baylor
nice pieces.
Baylor Cupp, baby.
Yeah, yeah. So offensive tackle Clayton Franks, he hit the portal. He's gone. Tight end Jed Castles went to Abilene Christian. Then you had defense lineman Devin Drew went to the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Quarterback Maverick McIver went to Abilene Christian.
That's tough to lose that. That's a guy you want on the roster right there.
He's got some BDE.
Yeah.
All right. He's got some BDE.
Maverick McIver? Gosh. Just keep him around for the name alone.
Yeah. Yeah. Defensive lineman Nelson Imbonasaur went to La Tech. Quarterback Henry Columbi went to Marshall. He's a starter there. And he started a lot of games for the Red Raiders last year. Then you have defensive end Trajan Lewis in the portal. Wide receiver Sterling Galvin, he went to Jacksonville State and Rich Rodriguez. They also lost who else? Running back Kyron Cumbie. So who's in the portal? Overall, I still think they won the portal. What do you think?
I agree. Columbi is a big loss. He was their leading passer, obviously, although 5 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. Ain't going to cut it
in
Kittley's system. I would say overall a win, though, 26 nationally, 5th within the conference in the transfer portal. Last 3 cycles of transfer portal, 25, 21, 26. They're doing pretty well.
They're doing well. They're doing it. Talk to me about recruiting rankings.
They are, I guess, pretty consistent. I don't know. 72, 65, 47, 54, 46. Getting better. 76 all the way down to 40 or 72 all the way down to 46 over the last 5 years. They're still toward the bottom end of this conference in terms of talent, number eight out of 10 overall in terms of composite talent. So maybe the system, though, lends it. Here's something where push has to come to shove here. I'm surprised they didn't lose their stud running backs to the transfer portal because they passed the ball second most attempts per game in the country and ran the ball second least amount per game.
But Baylor, Joey McGuire comes in from Baylor. He ran the rock there at Baylor.
So maybe something's got to give from a coaching standpoint.
A little bit of both, maybe? I don't know. Either way.
I say you lean on Kittley on this one.
They're must-watch TV with the Red Raiders this year. Patty C, if you're watching on YouTube, like I said, subscribe to the College Football Experience and the College Basketball Experience and go to youtube.com/thecollegeexperience. 5.5 wins is what they're saying in Vegas. Shout out to the SGPN graphics team. It's -110 on each side. So Vegas really kind of doesn't know what to expect. They're somewhere saying 5 or 6. They don't know. But, and I think that number is actually accurate. All right. But let me hop into it. Week one, AT&T Stadium in Lubbock. The Racers of Murray State. Somebody don't tell Bud Foster. They come into Lubbock.
I wonder if Justin Fuente has something to say about this. Wasn't he almost
the Frank Beamer or Murray State's coach? Yeah, right. They played at Murray State, right?
I think so. Yeah.
I got Texas Tech rolling them.
Yes.
Now, Patty C, last year, Texas Tech went into Houston and got the dub against Dana Holgorsen. Does Dana Holgorsen get revenge when they got to come into Lubbock?
Houston's supposed to be really good this year, right?
They were 12-2 last year.
Maybe the favorites in the American. A future Big 12 showdown here. I'll lean Houston. I don't know.
I'm taking Tech.
All right.
2-0.
They did win by 17 last year, so it's tough to take Houston there. Maybe you're right.
2-0, and then you got this 2-game stretch. That's tough. Actually, you can argue the 4-game. They can argue this whole schedule minus Murray State. Patty C, they head to Raleigh to Carter Finley Stadium.
I mean, if you were to believe the hype train around NC State, you would say this is a blowout for the Wolfpack. I don't think that's going to happen. I don't even know if I'm going to favor the Wolfpack. I think I might have to buy it just enough to give them a win, especially all the way halfway across the country in Raleigh, but it's going to be a good one.
How about this? Between this game at NC State and home to Texas the next week, go listen to our Texas preview. I think Raider fans might like me. I'm going to say they're going to be 3-1 out of the month of September. 3-1.
It's generous. I'm giving them 2-2.
Two and two.
Because what happened with the Texas game last year?
They got whooped
by 35, 5 touchdowns.
But it was in Austin.
2-2.
This is the last time they come into Lubbock. This place is going to be
rocking. It's going to be lit.
3-1 after September. Then they head to Bill Snyder Family Stadium. That's a loss.
Probably a loss.
3-2. Then they head to Boone Pickett Stadium to take on the Mullet. That's a loss. 3-3 for me.
Take on the Mullet. Yeah, that's a loss. Back to back road.
Then they
curious what they've done against K-State recently. I'm gonna dial that up, but keep going.
Dial that up. Then they get a bye week though after those two road games. And then they're hosting the Mountaineers of West Virginia.
They've lost 10 of their last 11 against K-State.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yikes.
So I got them at their bye week on October 15th. I got them sitting there at 3-3.
Buddy, I got them at 2-4, and they might be 1-5.
Then they get a bye week, and they host the Mountaineers of West Virginia. I got them winning that.
I feel like West Virginia has a harder time on the road. I'll give them a win there.
So it moved to 4-3. Then McGuire against his old coach, Aranda. It's in Lubbock. Dangerous.
Gonna get a little chippy.
I'm still gonna go Baylor
here. Gotta go Baylor here.
4-4.
Reigning Big 12 champions.
4-4.
Yeah.
Then I think this is the biggest stretch here. Because they're at TCU. I told you I like the McGuire hire better than the Dykes hire, despite I think TCU is a better roster year one than Texas Tech's. But I think we prove it right here. Give me their fifth win.
TCU winners are 3 straight for the last 5 here. Where's this game being played? Lubbock?
No, Fort Worth.
I don't know though.
It's a tough game.
It is a tough game.
Game. Don't know. Coin toss.
I'm leaning TCU.
Then they come home to take on the Kansas Jayhawks.
Especially because what's his name? Duggan is back for what? His super senior year here.
Yeah.
It's tough to get that one on the road. Anyway, Kansas.
I'll say this. They get one between TCU and Kansas.
Yeah, I'll agree with that.
Then they're at Jack Trice Stadium taking on Iowa State. I'm taking Iowa State.
Yeah.
Then they're home to Oklahoma the last time Oklahoma comes to Lubbock.
That's an L.
I think you're underestimating the last time effect.
I think you might be right, but let's check out the last 100 times they played Oklahoma.
I know, but I think it's different when you add that target and they're about to just completely destroy your bankroll.
Your world.
Yeah. I think it's different. I think they're going to get one of either Texas or Oklahoma. And you know what? They're going to get one of those two.
Buddy, 10 straight. I guess I can look. They have a little streak thing here. I don't need to count. 10 straight losses against Oklahoma. Is that a concern for you there, bud?
No.
Last three games lost by 39, 34, and 31. They haven't been close. You're just giving them a win.
Well, I said one of them, either Texas or Oklahoma. One of them's going
to
trip.
I think it's more likely to be Texas.
Well, all right.
They should have had Texas a few years back. I'm still mad about
the onside kicks. Me too.
I wanted them to get that so bad.
It sounds like you're on the under over there.
I am on the under. In fact, I almost want to lock the under here. I think it's a hard schedule, man. You didn't do yourselves any favors. Houston, a very up Houston, and then NC State on the road, a very up NC State. The only really guaranteed win on this schedule is Murray State. That's it. You could be 1-11.
Nah, it's not gonna happen.
They're better than that. Yeah. They're better than that. But bowling seems like a tall task.
I think it's the right hire. I think they gotta be patient.
Sure.
I'm thinking 5-7. I think the number's accurate.
You think it is?
I think it's I have it between 5-6. But when I go through, I gave it Murray State, I gave them Houston. I said either NC State or Texas will be one. That's three. I think West Virginia is four.
I'm curious about West Virginia. I want to see what they've done recently against West Virginia.
You know what? Give me the over.
Give me the over.
6-6.
You're reckless. They have won three straight against West Virginia.
6-6.
But I gave them that one. I say this team is like 3-9, maybe 4-8.
This is definitely not a lock. I think they're 5-7 or 6-6. I don't think they're going to be 7-5. I don't think they're going to be 4-8. I think they're 5-7 or 6-6.
Vegas is pretty damn close.
I think they know what the fuck they're talking about on this one.
All right. What are you doing though? Over or under?
Gun to my head. I believe in the higher. Give me the over.
All right.
6-6. They go to the Chimichanga Bowl.
No agreement here. 5-7 at best, and sitting on the couch during bowl season.
1-11, maybe.
Yeah, I mean, what do I think? What do I think? 4-8. What do I think?
4-8. Wow. Hey, I've been wrong before. Patty C's been wrong before. Who will be right? Only time will tell. Folks, subscribe to the College Football Experience, and remember, subscribe to the College Basketball Experience as well, and check us out on YouTube. YouTube.com/College Experience. Don't forget, folks, that the Sports Gambling Podcast, NFL Futures, they're going through team by team, all 32 teams. All right. You're a Cowboys fan, you're a Texans fan. Check it out. All right. And look, if you can go to iTunes and give us a 5-star review here on the College Football Experience, say some nice things about us, I'm going to put you in a very short raffle to win a gift card to the SGPN store. What are you doing? Come on, help us help you. All right. You know what helps us? Take a minute out of your day and help us. All right. You'd be surprised. What do they say? Pay it forward. Some shit like that. Pay it forward, folks. All right.
You drop the review.
Tyler Shuck's going to pay it forward. All right.
He's going to be paying it forward into the end zone.
It forward to us. All right. Maybe it's Donovan Smith. I don't know. But anyway, subscribe to all that stuff. Check out the NBA gambling podcast, the NHL gambling podcast, the fantasy football. If you have your draft right around the corner, fantasy football gambling podcast, MLB gambling podcast, USFL gambling podcast. You go on and on. Get the app. Hop in the Discord channel. Talk sports with us. It's a lot of fun. Patty C, he's on Twitter at Patty C831. I'm on Twitter at TheColbyD. Like I said, DM us that review. And if you do that, we'll send you, I'm telling you, we're going to hook you up. We're going to hook you up. At the Colby D, the College Football Experience is on Twitter at TCE on SGPN. NC Knicks on Twitter at NC_NICK. We are the College Football Experience and the College Basketball Experience. I'm on the over. Patty C's on the under. This is the College Football Experience, Texas Tech Red Raider style. You better start thinking about yours. And we out of here. Fight for your life.
Devils.
Devil's Digest, huh?
When it comes crashing down.